Hello everyone, today we are going to do experiment 2, which is kinetic with continuous sampling. The aim of this experiment is to study the effect of autocatalysis by sampling method. So you will be provided with 5 solutions, FA1, which is your ethane diol acid, FA2 is potassium manganate 7, FA3 is your sulfuric acid, FA4 which is your potassium iodide, and FA5 is sodium thiosulfate. You are also provided with starch indicator and also your distilled water. Okay, so your first step is to rinse your burette with your distilled water. Okay, make sure that the burette is closed. Then fill in the burette with just a bit of your distilled water. Then you will cap the top of your burette and gently rock it side to side while rotating. Okay. Then you will drain the distilled water into a waste beaker. Okay. Then for your next step, you're going to rinse the burette with the solution that you're going to fill it in. Okay, so you rinse it with FA5, which is your sodium thiosulfate. Okay, just fill the burette with a bit of your solution. Okay. Then do the same thing. Cap the burette and gently rock it from side to side. Okay, then drain the solution into your waste beaker. Okay. Then make sure that your burette is closed and fill in the burette with your FA5 solution. Remember to remove your filter funnel. Okay. And clamp it to the retort stand. Then after that, adjust the water level inside your burette so that you can get a reading. Once you are done with your burette, you will take a 100 cm cube measuring cylinder and a 250 cm cube beaker. Okay, using this 100 cm cube measuring cylinder, you will add 50 cm cube of FA1, which is your ethane diol acid, into the beaker. After that, using the same measuring cylinder, measure 45 cm cube of deionized water. Okay. So, add it into your beaker as well. Then after that, using a 10 cm cube measuring cylinder, measure around 5 cm cube of FA3, which is your sulfuric acid, into the beaker. Then add the solution inside as well. Okay. Give the beaker a gentle swirl so that all the solution mix well. Okay. Then use a 50 cm cube measuring cylinder, measure around 15 cm cube of your Fe4, which is your potassium iodide. Then set it aside. Okay, and using another 50 cm cube of measuring cylinder, measure around 25 cm cube of your potassium permanganate. So prepare your stopwatch, and you will need to start your stopwatch immediately when you add in your Fe2, which is your potassium manganate 7 solution, into the 250 cm³ beaker. Okay, so make sure your stopwatch is ready, and once you pour it in, start immediately. Okay, stir the mixture for around 10 seconds to mix it well. So once you have start the stopwatch, allow it to continue running for the whole duration experiment. You must not stop the stopwatch until you have complete your experiment. Okay? So after about 30 seconds, you need to use a pipette to withdraw 25 cm³ of the portion of reaction mixture and transfer it to a 250 cm³ conical flask. Okay? Of your pipette with the bottom of your conical flask, okay, to make sure all the solution was removed. Okay, then at the 2 minutes mark, okay, add in your Fe4 solution, which is a potassium iodide, which you have pre-prepared, okay, into the 25 cm³ beaker. And quench it. Okay, now it's 2 minutes. I will add in. Okay. I will swirl the solution to make sure that it mixes very well. The solution should turn brown or pale yellow at this point. Okay, record this time in minutes and seconds to the nearest second in your table provided. Then the next step, I will titrate the liberated iodine with Fe5, which is your sodium thiosulfate, until the color of the solution turns pale yellow. Okay. Okay. Then I will add in around 3 to 5 drops of starch indicator into the mixture inside the conical flask. Solution should turn blue-black color. Okay. So I will continue to titrate until this blue-black mixture turns colorless as well. Okay. Take note not to overshoot because you can only perform each titration once. Okay. Then you will record your reading of your titration into the table, which was provided in your experimental worksheet. Okay, then you need to take 3 further 25 cm³ sample from your reaction mixture and repeat the quenching and titration step, okay, with the quenching of each sample at 4 minutes interval, okay, as shown in the table.